Recording, so sorry. On the right side you see the machine. It's a vertical lathe at the end with a 5 meter diameter table. After that, I do some of the NC programmer for turning and milling machines in our shop, and at the end, like a CAD/CAM technologist for post CSE automation with NX Open at the end. So I create post processors with Post Builder. I create post processors with Post Configurator, both of them, and I mean, CSE, I'm not an expert, but I think I know what I have to do at some points, but not everything. At the end, I went over to Siemens PLM 2015, started here as a software engineer advanced, support the Post Configurator product. Last year, for half a year, I joined the customer success team. That was the main intention for this meeting here. So we want to get your customer feedback. We want to get in touch with you to drive the future a little bit more customer driven. And in beginning of 2019, this year, I overtake the role of the product manager for Post Configurator from Florian Weisse. I think some of you also know him. And at the end, now my responsibilities are, for sure, Post Configurator and post processing in general, automated tests with NX Open, for sure, customer help and support, like in the forum, especially for Post Configurator, doing workshops with partners and so on. And machine tool driver, that's more integrated and connected machine tool capabilities. That's a little bit on the future. So not yet, but everything is connected at the end. Maybe we will see. So what is this intention? As I said, we want to bring together post-processor developers, end users, or customers, and development side in this case, or in this meeting today, my side. In the morning, it was also Lily from Shanghai team, and which is in our team for Post-Configurator. Yeah, in general, to give you also some overview, what's new in post-processing area, showing and discussion on smaller technical topics. For sure, discuss predefined topics. And what I want to mention here, really, I mean, it's 1 hour, and we not have the time for really detailed technical training or something. This session has more the intent to identify maybe gaps, identify talk about problems you have in your current things that we improve our product, and in general improve NXCAM so that we have all a value of that. That is the main intention of that. And yeah, how you can contribute, give some feedback during the session for sure. So a good thing is we do that in the morning. So if you have some technical questions, just write it in the instant messenger, and I will take a look on that beside, and if I think I can directly answer them, I will answer them. Otherwise, we will do it on a later point. At the end, you can vote for your preferred topics for the next session. If you like it, maybe we will see if you like the sessions or not. I'm sure. And what I want to encourage everybody is, if you have a topic or a showcase you want to show for in one of the next session, please inform me before, and you can have a time slot, and it's can totally independent of it must not be post configured at the end, but it should something have to doing with post processing. And for example, if you want to showing some really cool stuff with also with Post Builder, you can do that. I'm to feel totally free to do that, and so that we have can discussions on that. So if you have a topic, please inform me. Some of the rules for this introduction, or not only for this session, in general for all sessions, any constructive feedback is welcome every time. So it can be also critical constructive feedback. That is one of the rules. For sure, during the session, the technical questions, as I said, ask them in the instant messenger when possible. And for sure, in open discussions, I think it's normal, don't interrupt the speaker, so everybody can really talk and not that we have in a mix of voices at the end. And at the end, technical questions for sure answered after the session in the forum. Okay, so let's jump over to the first part. Post-processor development applications. I just want to give you a few of how post-processing works in NX. Cam. I know there are really some expert in the call, so for those it's maybe not so interesting, but nevertheless, every time you can learn something. So let us take a look. At the end, I think the purpose of a cam system, it's everybody is clear about that. So at the end, we have a toolpath in, or we have our CAD model, we have our cam. There we created the toolpath. The toolpath contains the information of tool positions. We need something to convert that to the machine, to the real machine tool. And at the end, hopefully, we get the real part and hopefully in a good shape. That is what's at the end in very short description is the purpose of a CAM system. And for that we have our digital world in NX, and at the end it should be the same at the machining. That means that it's the similar one. Okay. What is the NX CAM toolpath? So yeah, the toolpath contains all the data that represents the sequence of the tool movements, like the linear moves, rapid moves, some additional information about feed rate, technology behind, and so on. And one interesting thing is that the toolpath can be output in different formats in NXCAM. So on the one side, we have our cutter location source files, which is can be used, for example, for third-party systems like iCam or whatever, to create the post-process output later on. You can also use it for different approaches for debugging purposes and so on. But it's not real. It's not real machine code, right? So it's just an internal format, or you can go with that format into a different CAM system if it's like the ISO CLSF and so on. Second thing, that is what we are talking mainly here. It's a post-processor, so controller machine specific and C code. So we will go in detail here later or with the next slides. And the third way at the end, maybe there's also a fourth and fifth way, I don't know, but in this case, we have also the NX Open API, and for sure you can also create a post-processor with NX Open API and outputs all the motion types, but then it's still a DLL, you don't have really a connection and so on. Okay, toolpath data structure. What? How is it built up? You have a toolpath at the end. That is what the toolpath in the hole in the operation navigator. Inside of that, you have like a path entity for the operations. So you have multiple operations. That is a path entity, and in each of that part entity, you have different path events. So, and these path events you are well known as a linear move, rapid move, normal rapid move, like machine controls, UDEs. This is what the path event at the end contains. So, very easy structure first here, nothing really magic. And what we do with this data, we use our MOM, and MOM means Manufacturing Output Manager, who asks himself what means MOM at the end, so Manufacturing Output Manager. And at the end, that is the mechanism to access the NX data and generate this formatted output. And at the end, this NX data includes the part information, the general CAM data, and for sure the toolpath, and the toolpath we using in CAM for application based on this MOM. And applications which use the MOM at the end, it's the UG post or NX post. Not dependent on any product here or application first, the shop docs and like the library mechanism for tools and so on. One interesting fact is at the end we use a TCL provided file from a TCL interpreter, and before or versions lower than NX 1201 MP1 using TCL 8.4, and after that version we use TCL 8.6, and for sure older versions have lower TCL versions, so but I think the most of us using 8.4 or 8.6 TCL. This for sure can be can sometimes you have problems then if we switch the TCL version, like with the TCL 8.6 it not co supports the clock command, for example, so we have to extend the TCL 8.6 library in NX with a clock command that it works again and so on. Yeah. So at the end, MOM, this contains this TCL interface, and that is what we're using in normal post-processing area. So what is at the end NX CAM post? It's an application, and that is really one important thing I want to mention. It's an application based on the MOM architecture. That means the MOM architecture is really the thing how you can output the toolpath. It's based on a TCL interpreter. To develop a post processor, there's an overlay to make it easier and to not writing all the TCL code again and again and again. And in the past, therefore, we have the Post Builder application, which is, I think, 20 years in the market or longer. 20 years, maybe a little bit shorter or longer, I don't know really. And since 2015, we introduced Post Configurator in his first version. At the end, if we're not talking directly from applications, at the end, this is a very innovative approach because it's highly customizable and or completely customizable, and at the end you can do everything because at the end it's only TCL. Keep that in mind, it's TCL, so you can do everything. And the application we build on top of that should make the life easier for the post developer at the end. So means makes the life easier for us all. So how normally this post data flow works in NX. So as I mentioned before, we have this NX data storage. Means it contains the parts, the CAM program, the path events. Out of this, it will generate, or at the end, it generates the events with all the variables, the MOM variables you are known, like MOM tool name, MOM posts, and so on. This is internally generated by the NX core at the end. All those things going to the NX post, and this NX post, just naming NX post here. A minimum requirement for a post processor is one TCL file, so that means the event handler who can handle those events, like the MOM linear move, like the MOM rapid move, and a definition file which contains like block templates, words, addresses, and so on. And only normally, if you, I mean, if you can try it at your own at the end. If you only have a TCL, empty TCL file and an empty dev file, that is just like an empty post processor for NX. And if you only add a procedure named MOM linear move in your TCL file and use MOM output literal, you get all linear movements at the end with this output literal. So that is not what we will do here. I just want to mention it, that is at the end the basic structure of it. And at the end, the NX post with, for example, Post Builder or Post Configurator, we provide standard libraries. Also with Post Builder, you have templates for the different controllers. The same for Post Configurator. At the end, both are applications on top. And those libraries give you the capability to reuse the things. You don't have to reinvent all the things again. At the end, this post creates your output file, and hopefully you are happy with the output. If not, you start to customizing the post processor, right? That's the normal way when you do customer projects or whatever. So because, as I mentioned in the beginning, or maybe just one short words, I think we can have a ongoing discussion on that maybe in the next sessions, because in the first session today for Asia Pacific, the surveys for the next session, a lot of people wishes future of Post Builder, Post Configurator, the roadmap, advantages, disadvantages, session of that. And today I want to show just simply a showcase for a complex machine with Post Configurator. And maybe we can also talk the next time about the future of the both tools. At the end, short, no, long story short. Post Builder will, there's no further development for Post Builder. It will be maintained, it will be there. You can reuse the application Post Builder, that is not the problem. But at the end, the development will be done for Post Configurator. That means this, like this interconnecting of with the kinematic and so on, this will be done with Post Configurator. Post Builder will be still maintained. It's not that we do nothing, and there you don't have to be afraid that we switch off a license, whatever. Sometimes you can read those things in a forum or whatever. Currently, there's no plan to retire the post-build application, but it's not. There's no ongoing development for that. That's in short to that. So let me show you this complex showcase. So switch to NX. So hopefully you will see my NX session here. At the end, what you see here, that is, it's not a commitment. That is currently the SIM19 out of the box sample. It's a 5-axis horizontal milling machine with V and W axis. It's still a little bit. It's in not in production. It's still in development, and may in future we will want to provide this as an additional sample in the out of the box things. What is a little bit special on this machine, for sure, it's the V and W axis, so it's a trilinear axis combination at the end. We have head devices and so on. Or currently, there's only one head device. That is what I want to show today with the multi-chain here at the end, that you got just in feeling how it works. So at the end, I just prepared two things. Want to show that first. So in this folder for I have on my installation, I have the SIM19. In the post-processor folder, I have the from the session tomorrow the post-processor, some backup demos and some tryout before the demo. At the end, there's a Synumeric folder that is currently empty, just a text file. And I just use it that I have direct the correct name so that I don't have to relink all this machine database stuff to not waste time. So let us create first a post processor here with post configurator. Means I open the application, create a new post processor here, and just saying the name. So let me go to the folder here. Wait a second, SIM19, post-processor Synumeric. Let me grab the name here. This one, okay. Put it in and say, okay, so I use a Synumeric 840D because the CSE driver currently behind it's also, it's mainly, or it's only Synumeric 840D currently. So I don't use any additional layers. That we can also talk in a different session if you want. Yeah. So after this post processor is created, the application will automatically be opened, and what you will see here, it added automatically chains. So what is a chain at the end? When we're talking from chains in NX, then we talking from kinematic chains. And kinematic chains, this kind of machine can have multiple kinematic chains. Like it can be used as a only 3-axis milling at the end. It can be used as a 4-axis table. It can be used with a dual head or different multiple heads, only with a right angle head, whatever. So you have multiple informations about that. When you just to show it, when I go to the definition of the kinematic structure, there's defined a kinematic chain, and two of them are defined here. That means the post processor, when you create the post processor, it will automatically reuse the information from here. So that means you have one location where you define the things, and it will be reused in the post processor directly. Without setting, I mean, you will see in a moment, you have to do some settings currently, but the main message is it will use the data from the machine tool builder first to create those chains. So when I now go back and let us assume I want to have an output for the table version. I want to have an output for if the head is mounted. So in the past, I mean, there are different approaches to do that also with Post Builder. So you can use a linked post. You can try to put all the things in one post processor and switch the kinematics between the operations. At the end, we do some similar thing also here. We take a look in the start of pass, but then the concept is different. So we're taking really a look on the chain. First, to use this chain, we have to set up something. For example, let me go to the real machine kinematics here. And if you have a multi-chain machine, the first thing is the default chain, that means the standard chain, which is normally used, should have the highest possible configuration. In this case, it can be a 5-axis head table, it can be a 5-axis dual head. You just have to switch the things. So let us assume in the we have the highest configuration is a 5-axis dual head, means like we mounted the AC head. So X, Y, Z is clear. We have the fourth axis, that is then the C axis from the head. Maybe let us keep the limits here. Really important, the fourth axis vector, so this one here. So we have a C axis, means the axis vector is 0, 0, 1. So change it here. So fifth axis is then the A axis. Axis type is a head. Keep us the limits as they are, and for sure we have a rotation, that means the fifth axis vector is rotated along the I vector. So let's first save the modifications. So and now we want first to we have set up the highest configuration. Now we want first to set up the I would say the easy chain, that means the 4-axis table. When I go to the step, it's currently empty, so there's no setting. That means if this chain is active in the post-processing one, it will currently use all default standard settings. To change that now, I go back to the default, go to the kinematic setting. Machine kinematics and saying, okay, the machine type, it's different, right? So add this property to the chain, this one. Our fourth axis leader is definitely different because it's a B, so add it to the chain. Axis type is not a head, it's a table, then added this one to the chain. So limits, let's keep them here, and for sure the axis vector is also different. So means add this one also to the chain. On top of that, so fifth axis, we don't have to take care. On top of that, we have the home positions. So in the default chain, I mean, at currently the highest value, so let us say 0, 0 and have it in mind, 8, x60 for the Z. And this one have a different home position, so that we see it directly in the output later on. So I also add those home positions to the chain. And let us do one additional setting, that is the plane output. So let us say, okay, for the X, Y, Z, B, there is not a cycle 800 support, it's a transverse rotation. So add this also to the chain. Maybe well, that is not what I want to do. Add also this one to the chain. So, and now that is the big thing. When I now change or switch to this chain, I have all the properties again here. And now I can change those properties. That means, okay, in this case, I want to output all plane output is supported. If the home position is different, for example, in X, it's then minus 1200, for example. And for sure, the important one, real machine kinematics, so that means that the correct solution is calculated. So it's not a 5-axis dual head, it's now a 4-axis table. And our fourth axis leader, it's a B axis. And yes, it's a table. And the axis vector, it's not 0, 0, 1. It's now 0, 1, 0. And save the modifications. So now, when I post-process, for example, this floor wall IPW operation here on the left side, which is facing or cutting those faces here, and it's mounted in under the spindle. That means directly in the spindle. The tool is mounted directly in the spindle. When I now post-process this operation, I still get, when I go up a little bit, I still get my default chain that means that C and A, because we set up it as a dual head. So, but what I know to want is that the four access chain is active. To do that, you have to do one last thing. You have to do a chain mapping. Under chain mapping, we understand in which condition this chain should be active. And for that, you have predefined things. So, like with priorities, that means is current or the default thing is mom channel ID, mom main MCS, machine mode, and mom carrier name. And for example, the mom channel ID is 1 and the main MCS is G55, whatever, then you assign at the end the chain. That is the condition you set here. Yet now you have multiple cases where the order maybe is not the correct one for you. And for example, in this case, for this machine tool, for me it's more interesting the carrier name, because my M spindle, it's the tool carrier name S underscore M, then I want to have my normal four axis table kinematic. If my tool carrier name is AC underscore head, then it should be use may the default one or the AC later on. So to reorder those things here, you have to go to the service file at the end. And because I don't want to bothering with writing all the code, I just prepare a small four lines code. Just insert it here. And for explaining, I said four lines. It's only copy three lines. Let me see. So, and these are really important, especially for this chain functionality. This is very powerful variables. They are named libge chain selection priority, and with those one, you can reorder the UI things here. That means if the carrier name for you is more important and you wanted to have it as a prior one condition, you can do that in reordering those things. Even it's also possible to create additional ones. That means just copy this line here, and for example, I have a fifth one. And I mean, make maybe no sense. Some say never no sense. For example, the tool name, or it can be also own variable. At the end, when I now save those things, click OK, you will see that in this chain mapping condition order, all the things are changed. So now I have a new priority. And on top of that, I have also my prior five condition for the mom tool name. So what I now have to do, okay, if the mom carrier name is S underscore M for the M spindle at the end, my assigned chain is the four axis one. That means the one we defined before. That is all what I have to do. So click save process, click save, and now post process. Scrolling up a little bit, and now you see I get my B axis value here. I get the home values of my home position values of this chain, and okay, A word is the same at the end as the 12 OV. So this is how you can really easily set up those chains. And at the end, let's just show me in a fast way. For the AC, you can do at the end the same. That means if I now have the head and I want to add also this chain, I recommend even if the default setting is the same, add them also to the chain. Because when you open the chain, you directly see which kinematic setting you used. And it doesn't. It not hurts, right? It's you see it and you know, okay, it's also on this chain. So do these things again here, just to showing that it's a head. So we need this one. We need the vector. For sure, we need the fifth axis also now. It's also a head. Let's keep the limits. Needs the fifth axis vector. Okay. And let us say this one support Cycle 800, so plain output to the 8C chain, maybe saying it's for all of them, and going here. So Now we it's similar before. We do the same again. Setting the properties here, saying okay, all cycle 800. Going to the real machine kinematics. At the end, it's the same because it's inherited from the default chain, so I don't have to change anything here. And the only thing I know I have to do again the chain mapping condition. So means go back to the default chain selection, chain mapping, and now you can use a condition for one chain, and it will automatically create a new condition with every chain you added here. You can also add this by TCL. It's named libgeconf@chain. Can take a look in the documentation for that, how to do that. So condition two means, okay, if the carrier name now is AC head, then our chain, active chain, should be the AC. So save the modifications. And for example, if I now post-process this operation, which is under AC head, we should get now an cycle 800 output. We should get AC rotation, and yeah, and we should get the values of the default home positions. So that is how this multi-chain works. And really, in short, I mean, as I mentioned before, it's not a totally technical deep training, but I want to show how easily it can be to set up those kind of machines here, machine tools here. And one additional thing, so you see currently there is only the tool change, so we don't have the head change inside of it. What you now also can do, I mean, you go to the general settings, say okay, the tool change, that is the standard one, tool change by number. So add this property to the chain. Go to my chain. Go to the tool change, and now you have two possibilities. I personally recommend. I mean, you can do your TCL directly inside of this window if you want. So you can just starting writing here mom start, mom output literal, whatever. What I personally more like is not to add the TCL here. Especially if you have more than one lines, I like more the idea to add an additional procedure in my service file or in a different layer, whatever, and just calling the procedure here. I will show you why I recommend that, why that is a value to do that in this way. So first, I need a new procedure. So use the autocomplete functionality, new proc, give me back the body. And inside of that, I just doing a mom do template for the existing one. That was the tool change. And what we need before the tool change is the head change. To keep it simple here, for sure, the best way is create a block template and call the block template and so on. To keep it simple here for now, to not waste the time, let me use a mom output literal. And in this case, in CSE, there's a command named hc, and it contains the head number, in this case one. So, and for sure, we have to give it a name, head change ac, for example. So, copy this proc at the end, click OK. Go to the tool change for the ac. And now I just calling my procedure here. So why I do that, or what is the value to do that in that way, is if you use the inherited option here. So all the things are stored in a customer level in the post processor at the end. But if you use the inherited option here, it will use the standard default or the standard value. The problem is when I now click inherited, save the modifications, and I have a lot of TCL maybe inside of that, it's away. That is why I put it in a custom procedure in my service file. If I do this that way, it's only needed to call my procedure again, and it's the knowledge, the intelligence is not lost there. That is why I do it. Okay. So let us have a final test. So select operation. Let us take a look that we get our HC1. So there we are, our HC1. Then there's the normal tool change. And now maybe let us have a short look that it's also work in simulation directly. I mean, as I said in the beginning, simulation is not completely ready, so please apologize any errors here which will comings up. At the end, let us check. So machine tool drive to the tool change position, get the head on it, driving back. Okay, and that is now because Cyc 800 is currently not implemented in this CSE driver. So. But that doesn't matter because we're talking about post-processor today. Okay, so that I think is first the live demo. Any questions until here? Or maybe if you have, you can also keep it for the discussion round at the end.
I had a question, Thomas.
Yeah.
If you show the chain again, with the AC, that I was wondering why you didn't include the XYZ axis on that chain.
Okay, so let me open
In
my demo.
Post Configurator, does it take the default axis?
Right.
Well,
So
we did
it's.
it on the 4-axis XYZB, and then with the AC head, we didn't put it on there.
Right, I don't didn't put the
On the
XYZ axis because it's using if a property is
from
not defined here, it will use the default value.
Gotcha. Okay, thank you.
So, and I mean that is the main intention because when switching a chain or in kinematics, maybe 80% of the post processor are the same, but you have only to change some kinematic settings that you get the correct output again. And
Right.
all the things are working in the same way. So why do we define all the things again? That's the big value of it. Okay.
Got it. Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, then if there are currently no other questions, then let's go over to the next point. EVP, Early Validation Program. I think some of you are aware of that, how it works. Some of you may be not knowing what it is. What is my personal intention of that? I want to encourage you to participate on this program, especially for Post Configurator if you want, for new upcoming features. And because so. I mean, this is a really big chance for all of us, for you, for me, for other peoples like in Asia. So we can drive the future a little bit. We can take advantage of those tools and improve the product. And to do that and to get also this feedback during development, we have this early validation program. So what is it? At the end, you get a pre-release version of NX. So means you can participate on that. You get it's not really software, it's not production ready, but you can test features. You get a license where you also can test other features at the end. But for sure, at the end, what we expect there is some feedback from you. And at the end, we want to do an early validation of a solution and against this functional requirements and. Because when we identify early some issues in the code and especially when these features are tried out with use cases, with real use cases and not constructed use cases, then we can really improve the software, make it stable, more stable, and have all at the end we have a win-win situation on that you don't are annoyed of opening PR again and again in a released version. I mean, software development, it's still, yes, for sure, you have a bug sometimes, it will happen. But I think with this kind of pre-release versions, we can cover a lot of those PRs we get in the past. So, and at the end, as you see here, it's adjust plan, do check, adjust plan, do check, and so on. So what are our commitments from Siemens to that? At the end, we explain the functionalities that is being developed to you. So you can be take care on we name it sharing demos in our development teams, where we show you the feature, where we show you and where you can directly bring in your feedbacks, for example. For sure, we support the customer here, receive and evaluate the feedback, and that's the main intention. We use this feedback to provide this functionality that's really match to your customer expectations. And because we are in this post-processing thing here, I think maybe in the past sometimes this customer expectation and the development goes not on one line. And I personally, now as a responsible product manager, want to change this behavior so that we go all together in the right direction and the correct direction, and also think about things which influence really the future and this product. For sure, customers are committed to test those functionality they are involved with, so and to provide us feedback, timely feedback. So I normally do that in a short call, like 50 minutes. It's not take so much time, so you can have a short call on the feedback. You get a document for me, what you have to test at the end. It's like two features, not more. It's not a mass on features, so don't be afraid of that. And then we just have a short call, give some feedback, talk about the feature, what you think. Maybe you think something is not so good, then we can directly change it in development, and that is very, very good to do that. And for sure, look, incident reports, if there are other problems discovered, like internal error, something like that happens sometimes. So then it's better to have those ones in a pre-release version than in a released version. If you are interested in general, so like you see a presentation on a future project, wherever you see that, you can contact those NXCamp presenter. And especially for post configurator features or post processing, if you want to participate on that, just write me an email. So that means, how to participate. At the end, the customer can contact their customer champion, the camp presenter, or product manager. And for sure, what we also do from our side, from product managers, we also try to select customers or we search for customers from existing ones, from ever who are already joined those EV early validate program. At the end. Not want to talk so much about it at the end. You have to, or you need a non-disclosure agreement to get this EV early validate program version. And but that is normally it's taking 1 week in the whole process to get those things together. And at the end, this defines the scope of this agreement. For sure, that it's be confidential, that you don't show the software in other areas or in make a video and put it on YouTube. That is not the intention of that. And so at the end, you confirm the software is provided as is. That is not a production readiness feature. So if you are interested, especially for, as I said, post configurator, you can contact me every time you want and participate. Okay. So I think we are good in time. In the morning it was a little bit slower, but okay, that's good. First question answer discussion survey. I have w prepared one thing. Let me show that. At the end, it's a short, really short survey. Will provide you the link in the instant messenger. This one contains, wait, so let me put it here. So this link, it's a SurveyMonkey questionnaire survey. Contains three questions, and I really appreciate any feedback here directly in the call to, from that. So we do it also in the morning. Just let me open it and to just show it in short. So there are three questions. The first one, if you like the session today, that's one of the prerequisites. So which topics you want to see discussed in the next session? You can show us three items. I predefined some of them. But for sure, put other topics if you want to see other topics and you don't find it here. The general question, what do you think you get a value of this event today? Or if there's something we can improve or I can improve, please write it. Be honest. I don't track any names there. It's just collecting the answers. And the third point is also one question. So if you can decide on upcoming features for Post Configurator, what would you prefer for future? And there are also some of predefined things. And if you're thinking about other things, then please add them also here. And yeah, feel free to do that now when we have maybe some ongoing discussions. I open the question and answer round and not, I mean, in general, ask what you want. Okay, si silence is not good. I mean, maybe
That
some.
means everybody was overdoing the survey, right?
Maybe, yeah, but maybe.
Hi, Thomas. This is Jeff Moss from New
Hi,
York.
hi, Jeff.
I just wanted to say I thought the 1 hour format is good. Allows us to take a little bit of time out of the day, do some learning, and the content is valuable. So my feedback is continue.
Okay, so you put it directly on the SurveyMonkey?
Working on it.
Ah, okay. I mean, maybe in the meantime, I can also tell some additional things, and you can concentrate on your other things. There was because you know I also read often the manufacturing forums, sometimes answering that. And this week, I think there was a good discussion about out of the box samples. It belongs to the post builder posts, which are not longer content in the out of the box post process or out of the box samples in AT47. I just want because there were some discussions. I want to know you that as I said in the beginning, Post Configurator will be the future development tool, and at the end the. In our out-of-the-box samples, we have Post Configurator and we have Post Builder posts in the past. That means for us in development, it means we have a double maintain. So we maintain the Post Builder post, we maintain the Post Configurator post. Because the MOM architecture, if there are some changes, we have to change both of the post processors. And also for new customers who come on board with NXCom, they are confused, right? They are confused about thinking, okay. I have two post processors for Synumeric. Okay, and both at the end have mostly the same output. But the one is a post build application, the other one post configurator application. And they are confused about those situations. And I personally think today we are in a good shape to really go forward now with post configurator. If somebody asked me maybe 2.5 years before, I would say, yeah, okay, maybe not the best one. Today I would really say, yeah, you can use it, you can modify everything, you can do everything. And okay, so there was one additional question. Is it possible to build a post configurator post processor using no libraries with completely open code? No. There's one thing. I cannot not show it today because that is an upcoming feature. We have a first version, and maybe that is interesting for you to join EVP. It's named controller template. So this one, it's I think already developed. So it's in a final phase. This one is a pure native TCL file. Wait, let me maybe show just the TCL. It's not showing the complete version. One second to search it. Library. So in the next release, there will be this one will be contain a controller that is named template. This one will be completely open. It's a completely open TCL file. At the end, the implementation in this post-processor or in this controller is the same like a FANUC one or a Synumeric one. But without specific Synumeric settings, without specific FANUC settings, without specific Heinheim settings. So, but the implementation itself, it's at the end, it's a completely open controller. And the architecture, how to implement the things, are completely open and you can reuse it. What we will not open in future is the standard functionality. Standard functionality means the file handling, how to create the file on the hard disk, and so on. But therefore, you can also change it in TCL during runtime. I hope this first will answer this question. So then I think ask the question. Okay. So and there's a second question from Frank. Will be able to convert. Okay, that's good then. And the question from Frank will be able to convert PB POS into PC POS. Currently, no. So currently, no. And I think the most of the people knowing that, because the archi, or not maybe not all of them, but the architecture is completely different from the architecture how they build up. What I can really imagine me, and we have a small prototype. That is why I'm a little bit not directly say no. We have a prototype to get things out of the PB post and implement it on the correct place on the post configurator post. What's still missing in this prototype, it's we you know you in Post Builder you add your custom commands, you have your condition blocks and so on. This is something where we have to find a generic algorithm to get out this information to set it at the correct place. And I would not say it's impossible, but for example, I would say for until 5 axis machines, for normal ones, it should be possible. And maybe we have to invest. And hopefully, if you all in the survey now clicked on or added migrate PB to PC, then I think it will raising up in development. At the end, currently no, but we think about that. Just let me read für PC, wenn der Drückentopf. Okay. I think we have still 3 minutes. I mean, this is the one we can also touch in one of the next session. In Post Configurator, at the end, if you touching block templates, you have a definition file editor in general that is not belonging. I think you are talking more about add a custom command to a block. In Post Configurator, first for the definition file, we have those definition file editor. where you can change things directly inside. You have a drag and drop option. You can create those block templates. As I said, I want not to go in detail here, so we can do this in one of the next session. At the end, very powerful. You have all the things you need on one dialog. The other thing to modify TCL or to jump into commands, there's a new tool that is named Inspect Tool. It's a extended debugging tool at the end. So let's switch me on. Show Inspect Tool, Post Process. And at the end, you get here the structure of the post processor. So you can search for variables. You can take a look from the NC side. For example, clicking on that, you see which MOM event is behind which buffer ID. You see all the MOM variables. You can copy the variables from here if you want. And buffer events, that is what I mean. For that, we have to do an extra session. And I will do that. That is how you modify it, for example, between the lines and add your additional procedures. So you have predefined things like this command buffer here, can edit and then add your TCL things additional on top of that, and that in each point of that. Okay, so hope this first also answers the question from Derek. And one last question from Joyce, John Joyce. Yes, this session will be available later. Unfortunately, I started the recording 5 minutes later, so after my personal introduction, but I think it's fine. We have the same session at the end in the morning with Asia Pacific, and I will upload one of the sessions, or maybe I will upload both of the sessions to the manufacturing forum. If somebody really needs a hard copy on the hard disk, then please send me an email and I can provide it with our internal file transfer system. Okay. Then, any other questions? Sounds like a no currently. So, yeah, what I want. There was one ping again. Ah, thank you. Okay, yeah, Frank, you're welcome. Okay, so what I will do is from the survey, I will send out for the next invitation the most voted topics so that you hopefully you will find yourself inside of that. And then I would say thanks for the joining. Have a great weekend, which is starting now in Germany. And so I go to drink a beer now. And hopefully we will see us in 6 weeks. And as I mentioned, if there's really something special posted in the NX manufacturing, or you can also directly contact me. Okay?
Thank you, Thomas.
Yeah, thanks,
You're welcome,
Thomas.
then.
Thanks, Thomas.
Have a great rest of the day. Bye.
You too.
Enjoy your beer.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you. Bye.